a promise. I am a possibility. I am a promise. With a capital P. I am a great big bundle of potentiality.
Bah, 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 bah.
And I am learning to hear God's voice, and I am trying to make the right choice. I am a promise to be anything God wants me to be.
Hello, everybody. Today we are in Texas, but thanks to technology, we can do children's story. And guess who I found?
Hi, everybody. It's so good to be here with you all. Happy Sabbath, boys and girls, and to parents that are watching.
Well, today's story is going to be all about holding on to what you should hold on to. What should you hold on to?
You should hold on to the hand of God and those that guide you in the right direction.
The Bible does say that you should honor your father and mother, and your days will be longer on the land. I think they also meant to listen to our elders, our big sisters, our teachers. Let's listen to their story and see what it's all about.
My story today is about me and my sister. We grew up always sharing a room, seemed like we're inseparable. We had to go to school together, church together, and the house together.
All the time?
Most of the time.
Mercy.
The time that we weren't together was maybe like when we're at school in our own classes. So, one time we were together, and I decided that I was gonna be a little bit of a daredevil. Now, as you know, I have a habit of that. Always living on the edge, always getting in a little bit of trouble. Well, this particular time, I decided that I was going to climb out the window and jump downstairs to go to my friend's house. Mama told me, don't go out the house. But I decided that since I couldn't go out the front door because my older brother and sister were in the living room, I took my own little detour out the kitchen window. Happens to be, at the time I was 9 and I just was not tall enough to reach the ledge that was below the window, that I guesstimated in my mind that was. So I put one foot out the window and I grabbed onto the ledge and I started to slide the other leg out the window. And just so happens, my sister Sharika decides to come walking to the kitchen. Yeah, the suspense builds. The first thing out of my mouth, don't tell mom, don't tell dad. I'm just going downstairs to see my friend Johnetta, and I'm gonna come right back in, but I'm gonna need you to open the door when I come back in and make sure Jackie and June were in the living room. Well,
those are your brother.
As I'm trying to get that out, I hear keys at the front door. Now mind you, I am hanging half out of the window, holding onto the ledge. So I tell Sharika to come help me and pull me back inside. She goes to try to pull me back inside. That didn't work. Luckily for me, the keys that I heard at the door happened to be my aunt coming in the door, but she just came to drop something off, so she went back out the door. So I'm still holding onto the ledge, and Sharika's still pulling me, trying to get me back inside. That didn't work. Time goes on, y'all, it gets really bad. My brother and sister decide to leave the house to go to the carryout. So Sharika's still in the kitchen, and they're like, we'll be right back. Y'all stay here, be good. She just says, okay. So as she says, okay, Sharika panics, starts to get scared. I'm still holding on, y'all. That's the same type of way that when we do things in disobedience, God doesn't let go of us. He still continues to hold on to us. My sister panicked really bad. So she said, hold on as tight as you can. I'll be right back. She runs out the kitchen. She goes to the phone. She dialed 911. By the time my brother and sister make it back, the fire department is outside. They're coming to the back window to save me, because by this point she can't pull me back inside. She done got tired. She's scared. Thankfully, she knew our address to even tell them where to go. So as the ladder is coming up to the back of the apartment, my mom comes home from work. Y'all, when I say it's a good thing to not just try things at home, to be obedient, you know, stay in place when you're supposed to stay in place, it's a very good thing to listen to your parents, to listen to your older brothers and sisters, because a lot of times we don't feel like it as being young people that the older people know everything. They tell us these things to keep us safe. Long story short, I got whooped by my mom. I got whooped by my dad. I got whooped by my brother June. And I got grabbed by my sister Jackie. Guys, it's important, important to be obedient and to listen to those who know a little bit more than you. But like I said, thankfully I had a sister who was smart enough to think, I need help, I gotta get help, because the older ones had left the house. Guys, we gotta learn to listen. We're living in a day and age where things happen just like that in the blink of an eye. And it's so dangerous out here. Listen to your parents, listen to your elders, listen to your big brothers and sisters, because a lot of times they're telling you things just to save your life. Be obedient, boys and girls. And have a happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath. It's prayer time. Corey, would you pray that we would hold on and listen to the Most High?
Dear God, I thank you for the people that listen, hold on, and listen to their respectful, be respectful and kind to each other, and they're being kind and welcome to something and learning who God is, and learning who Jesus is. He's our Lord. He's protected us from danger. Amen.
Amen. Amen.